The legendary LA Dodgers announcer Vin Scully once said, "Losing hurts more than winning feels good." And you can't help but think the South Dakota State Jackrabbit women's basketball team feels that way right now as they lose a heartbreaker 66-65 to the Stanford Cardinal in the second round of the NCAA Tournament.
This is a tough loss for us, you know, having that on the line, knowing that we could be the first Jackrabbit team to make it to the Sweet 16, I think, you know, pumped us up a lot, you know. And you know, before the game, the locker room, we were just all jacked and just fired up and ready to go. And yeah, we played really good, you know, but you know, they made runs and we made runs. And sometimes, like in games like this, it just comes down to the little plays, you know, a rebound here or there, you know, getting a stop on defense, you know, finishing a play. It's just plays like that at the end, you know, it comes down to those little things in the game.
The critical situation came late. The Jacks were up 65-63 with less than 20 seconds to go, but Stanford got a driving layup on a questionable foul call, and they converted the three-point play to take a one-point lead.
I'd say we just had a little breakdown there. We let her drive in, and we got a kind of a bad foul there, and she made an and-one, and you know, credit to her, she made a great layup and a free throw that won them the game.
So with 8 seconds left, SDSU had one more chance to try and win the game. It was a play designed to get Macy Miller open for a shot, but she passed it up once. Ellie Thompson passed it up once, and Macy's final desperation shot was blocked at the buzzer.
We ran a play jersey to come off a screen, and you know, I passed it to Ellie, and time was running down, so I thought I might as well just drive in and try to get foul and contact, but it just didn't happen.
A little bit more of some of that high ball screen we were in earlier in the game throughout the end of the third, into the fourth. I really thought Mace probably had a look and then gave it back to Ellie. Ellie had a good look and maybe needed to move away from that pass. But it's just, you know, a pressure situation that's really tough and ended up with probably a tougher shot than maybe we had to take right there.
It's hard to criticize any portion of the Jacks game. They gave it their all. They were gritty. They were tough throughout. But one key stat leaps off the page. Madison Giebert, the freshman shooting sensation, just 1 of 4 from the field, and she didn't even attempt a single three-pointer.
Yeah, I think they just really put a lot of pressure on her. They made the decision that they weren't going to let her get a shot off, and that's okay too. You know, as she felt that pressure, it also opened up some other things. We had some penetration lanes because of it. Ellie was able, I think, to get to the basket a few times when Maddie was in her side and they wouldn't help. So, you know, one door closes, other things open. So that it didn't disappoint me. You know, teams can take things away if they choose to. I thought we took some things away too, but it also opened up some other things that I think created some offense for some of our players.
When the South Dakota State men's team lost to North Dakota State in the Summit League Championship last year, head coach Scott Nagy talked about how because his team was so invested in the game, so invested in the season, that's why it felt so bad. That's why the hurt felt so deep. And Aaron Johnston said it felt the same way for the Jackrabbit women.
Probably be quite a while before I go back and watch this, but you know, when you lose, you just have there'll just be those little levels of regret. You know, should we have, what about this, maybe this is a better call in that situation. And that's the hardest part, I think, as a coach, and I would say probably even players too, is just that regret that comes with these kind of losses. You know, that's the part that's hard to get past.
South Dakota State graduates only 2 seniors, Gabby Bover and Chloe Korneman, who were both bench players this season. So the entire starting five will be back in 2016-2017, along with some key additions. And that has Kerri Young, Macy Miller, and Aaron Johnston excited about what's to come.
Right now it's an awful feeling, but we got to keep our head held high because of what we've accomplished. And I wouldn't trade these girls for anything, and I'm excited for next year.
I feel really good about the future. I'm not quite in the future right now. I'm still dwelling on the past. looking at the roster, it's a really good roster, really talented. It's young. We've got great players that will join us next year. The future is very, very bright, and you heard the comments from Kerri and Macy. I think they sense that as players, too, and they're really excited about it.
All in all, a very successful season for the South Dakota State women's basketball team. As you saw, Kerri Young, Macy Miller, and even Aaron Johnston were pretty optimistic for next season, even in the immediate aftermath of the one-point loss to Stanford. But now the goal for next year is crystal clear.
We're a young team, and that's something we're looking forward to next year is, you know, to even be better than we were this year and, you know, to get farther than we were this year and, you know, to make it to the Sweet 16 next year. That's something that we're going to, you know, we're going to have our standard higher than we did this year.
That's really going to motivate us. Right now, like I said, it's an awful feeling. And we have 5 of us coming back and, you know, coming into this tournament, we're going to have veterans and we're going to know what it feels like to play every game and what how it feels when you lose. And We're excited for next year.
We've had just an unbelievable following over the years, and it's a special group. I always use the phrase shared experiences, and that's really what this is all about in college athletics. You know, it's not my thing. It's not our team's thing. You know, you're representing, we're representing a university here, a state, and all of these shared experiences really connect people in a way that you just wouldn't get if you're taking a vacation. And sometimes these shared experiences just punch you right in the gut like this one does. And we're going to share this. And if any of you want my feeling, come and take it, because I'd like to get rid of some of it. But it's an amazing thing in athletics to have those kind of shared experiences. And we're lucky to have a wonderful group behind us.
So the Jacks get their second NCAA tournament win with a first-round victory over the University of Miami 74-71, and then lose a heartbreaker to Stanford 66-65. With the Jackrabbits in Palo Alto, California, I'm David Brown.